Hello everyone, welcome to Instrumentation Academy. In this video, we will discuss the types of photoelectric sensors and their working. A photoelectric sensor is used to detect the presence or absence of an object or for measuring the distance between a point and an object utilizing light. Photoelectric sensor is a popular choice in factory automation since they provide quick and reliable results without physically touching the object. There are several industrial applications, especially within manufacturing, where the distance and absence or presence of an object needs to be measured. A photoelectric sensor is used for such purposes. A photoelectric sensor basically consists of an emitter for emitting light and a receiver for receiving light. Emitter converts the electrical signal to light energy and emits the produced light as a beam of either visible light or infrared light. Usually, LED or laser diode is used as emitter. When emitted light is interrupted or reflected by the sensing object, it changes the amount of light that arrives at the receiver. The receiver detects the change in light and converts it into an electrical output. Usually, photodiode or phototransistor is used as receiver. The electrical quantity is then amplified by an amplifier and is checked by detection circuits, which verifies that the light was emitted by its own emitter and sends a signal to output circuit indicating that an object is detected and triggers an output. Photoelectric sensors are available in different shapes and sizes. This makes these sensors suitable in many industrial applications. Photoelectric sensors are classified into three main groups on the basis of sensing method. They are through beam sensors, retroreflective sensors, and diffuse reflective sensors. Each model offers varying light emission methods, though they are all highly efficient when it comes to distance detection. Now let's discuss each sensor in detail. Through beam sensors. Through beam sensors are photoelectric sensors with a separate transmitter and receiver which are placed facing each other. This is also called a through beam configuration. In this type, an emitter sends out a beam of light directly in the line of sight of the emitter to a receiver. When an object breaks this beam of light, it reduces the amount of light that enters the receiver. This reduction in light intensity is used to detect an object. Advantages of through beam sensors. As the light from the transmitter falls directly on the receiver, through beam sensors offer the longest optical range and it also offers highest possible signal strength. Surface reflectivity and color of the object being detected have no effect on sensing. Limitations of through beam sensors. This type of setup requires separate emitter and a separate detector, which makes it a bit more complex to install and wire. Alignment of emitter and receiver can be difficult. Retroreflective sensors. Retroreflective photoelectric sensors are photoelectric sensors with a reflector. The photoelectric retroreflective sensing mode is also called the reflex mode or simply the retro mode. The emitter and receiver are installed in the same housing and light from the emitter is normally reflected back to the receiver by a reflector installed on the opposite side. When the sensing object interrupts the light, it reduces the amount of light received at the receiver. This reduction in light intensity is used to detect the object. Advantages of retroreflective sensors. As the emitter and receiver are on the same housing, one wiring location is only required. Sensing distance ranges from several centimeters to several meters. Operation not greatly affected by the color or angle of sensing objects. These are good for transparent, large, and reflective objects as well as objects moving quickly. Disadvantages of retroreflective sensors. Sensing objects with a mirrored finish may not be detected because the amount of light reflected back to the receiver from such shiny surfaces makes it appear as though no sensing object is present. Retroreflective sensors have a dead zone at close distance. Diffuse reflective sensors. Diffuse photoelectric sensors are similar in some respects to retroreflective sensors. As in retroreflective sensors, emitter and receiver are located in the same housing. In retroreflective sensors, reflectors are used to bounce the light back to the receiver. But in the case of diffuse reflective sensor, the object to be sensed itself functions as the reflector. The emitter and receiver are installed in the same housing and the light normally does not return to the receiver. When the light from the emitter strikes the sensing object, the object reflects the light and it enters the receiver where the intensity of light is increased. This increase in light intensity is used to detect the object. Advantages of diffuse reflective sensors. Sensing distance ranges from several centimeters to several meters. Easy mounting adjustment. They are good for detecting multiple and translucent object, fill level inside containers and object orientation. Disadvantages of diffuse reflective sensors. Sensing can be affected by color, texture, dirt and other factors. Now let's discuss photoelectric sensor outputs. The output of photoelectric sensors are of two types. They are digital or analog outputs. Digital output. A digital output is commonly called a switched output. A switched output has only two states, on and off. This on and off states commonly refer to the status of the load that the sensor output is controlling. The load might be an audible alarm, an indicator light, a switching relay, or a PLC. As we know, for inductive or capacitive sensors, we use normally open and normally closed to define the sensor's output when an object is detected. Similarly, in photoelectric sensors, light on and dark on is used to define what the sensor's output is doing in absence or presence of light at the receiver of the photoelectric sensor. These terms apply only to photoelectric sensors. Light on refers to the state that the receiver of the photoelectric sensor receives sufficient light. In this mode, the output turns on or load is energized when the receiver detects the light from the emitter. Dark on means there is no light reflected to the receiver of the photoelectric sensor. In this mode, the output turns on or load is energized when the receiver receives no light. Consider that a through beam sensor is connected to a bulb and a retroreflective sensor is connected to another bulb. In both these cases, the receiver receives light normally from the emitter even before the object interrupts the beam of light. In light on mode, as the output is energized when the receiver receives light from the emitter, the bulb glows. While in dark on mode, as the output is not energized when the receiver receives light from the emitter, the bulb will be switched off. In diffuse reflective sensors, as the receiver does not receive the light normally from the emitter, in light on mode, the output will not be energized, so the bulb will be off. While in dark on mode, as the output will be energized when the receiver does not receive the light from the emitter, the bulb glows. Sinking and sourcing. A sensor output can source or sink power. Sourcing power means the sensor output supplies a positive voltage when the sensor turns on. This is called a PNP output. A sinking output connects the load to the negative supply voltage that is also ground in many systems. These connections are called NPN outputs. We have already discussed about sinking and sourcing concepts in a previous video. Link of that video is there in the description. Analog output. An analog output is one that varies over a range of voltage or current and is proportional to some sensing parameter. The output of an analog photoelectric sensor is proportional to the strength of the received light signal. Sensors with analog outputs are useful in many process control applications where it is necessary to monitor an object's position or size or translucency and to provide a continuously variable control signal for another analog device like a motor speed control. By this, we come to the end of this video. If you like our video, please click the like button below and make sure to click the subscribe button and the bell icon also so that you can get notifications of our further videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.